Honestly, she could have easily have been that bot lane multiple times, but whatever. At least she's doing fairly well. Unironically.
Oh, I forgot that it turns off the sound when they click off of it. Hello, Blue Jay! Currently getting some stuff set up. Hello, my totally new friend. Hello, Cereal! How are you doing, my dude? Are you having a good time? Can you guys hear me okay over the sound of the game? If you guys, like, I don't know how to sound balance this yet because I didn't want to go in to test it before it, because I don't want to, I want to experience this all with you guys. So, let me know if you guys can hear me alright. Heck yeah! Just give me one more second here. Meanwhile, are you guys having a great time? Yeah, everything's good. That's good. Alrighty. Music's gonna cut off all weird. Oh yeah, it's been a while since you've been on, hasn't it, my dude? 3, 2, 1. Heck yeah, let us go! Hello! The Gibby can dance. It's great. I'm going to turn off Snaz actually first really quick. And make it so that I can see everything. Give me 1 second. Move this down so I could see how my sound is registering. There you go. But yeah, no, if you type in F-U-D, you will feed the bee. You can also type in dance and he'll do a little dancey-do. It's great. Good night, we'll put the bee to sleep. And if you say grr in chat, he'll get angry. You can also hug the bee by saying hug. So yeah, let's get this show on the heckin' road. E to wake up. He is just a silly little goofy guy. Put hug in not in all caps. The ground with the mouse. Oh, what? What is jumping in this game? That is interesting. You gotta hold and release. So you can't just spam the jump button. Okay. Huh. I wonder what kind of... Oh, hey, we have a friend! You can roast marshmallow! We're doing that. Yep, this is how we're going to spend our time here. Oh, you press shift to extend the stick. Oh, oh no, oh no, I burnt my marshmallow. That's lame. Let's eat the marshmallow. Blah. Yeah, I agree with you, dude. All right, let's extend it up here. Not into the fire, because we do not want a burnt marshmallow. Burnt marshmallows are heckin' lame. I want a nice and golden... golden marshmallow. Let's go. Little smoke particles coming off of that. That's really pretty. I love that. But away is cute. I love that. We have a little friend. You've played this once as a demo and you loved it? Fair enough. I can talk to this guy. Am I gonna explore first or talk? You know, I should probably talk to the guy before I do too much exploring. There's our pilot. Back from your pre-launch camp out under the stars, I see. So it's launch day, huh? Seems like only yesterday you joined the space program, and suddenly here you are, leaving on your first solo voyage. What do you say? Ready to get this beauty off the ground? It's all fueled up and ready to go. All systems go, I'm ready if you are. You're sure you fixed the retro rockets. Let's go, all systems go. Glad you're excited, but remember, if you wreck the ship, I am not building you a new one. I am not made of lightweight, re-entry-grade aluminum alloys, you know. Anyway, you'll need to get the launch codes from Hornfels at the observatory before you can lift off. Just bring those here once you've said your goodbyes or whatever. Got it. So I'm going to assume... Can I jump? No, I can't get up there. So that's where we're launching off from. Oh, it's a little sleeping bag. I have dots on my arms. Really, Terry? You can run whilst crouched and ready to jump, though. Is there anything down this way first? Oh! There's a geyser! Oh, I love the little water graphics. It looks so fluffy. Geysers are not fluffy, though. You don't touch those. I gotta be careful of spoilers. I'm guessing there's a lot of spoilers out there then. Cereal, without spoilers, like both of you guys, everybody, without spoilers, what is your favorite part of the game? Without spoilers, though. Because I literally know nothing about this game. Oh, you can fly a model ship? Oh, wait. Oh, no. Reset. Alright, horizontal thrust, up and down thrust is CTRL and shift. Nothing happened. No, wow, I'm... Something tells me that I'm not gonna be very good at flying ships in this game. Oh no. Up. Oh no. Up.
Why does everyone talk to me? I don't understand. Like, she literally...
Let's try this again. Up. Up. No. Up. That's not. Nope. Nothing happened. We got this. It's a game with no replay value. Once you know something, there's no going back. So you just have to not look up anything. Oh, that's fair. That's fair. Perfect. We'll just go up forever. I know I could do that. How far can we go up with this little guy? He's leaving.
Oh yeah.
Look at him go, just a little speck off in the distance. You barely see him glowing around there. Did I send him into the atmosphere? Come back, sir. Wait, I don't see him anymore. Did I just send him into nothingness? I killed him! No! Oh, no, no, see, look. He's fine. See, he's right there. He's fine. Your favorite part without spoilers has to be flying around. That's his brother. No, no, it's the same guy. Everything's fine. Everything is fine. See, look, there he is. There he is. He's having a good time. Right in front of us. Why is he slightly going forward? Come back. Not in my face, please. Okay, I'm kind of oh, no. No. Oh, no. Nothing happened. I'm slowly figuring this out. Slowly. Try to land him on the moon. You can do that. Where did the moon go? I don't see the moon. Let's reset. Oh! The moon's gone now. Wait, nothing happened. Moon, come back. Yeah, the moon just kind of left, guys. I don't know if I can... I killed... No, he's right there. He's right there. He's fine. Heck, now it's daytime. Okay, I want to put him... Can I put him into the sun? I feel like that would be even less effective than putting him into the ground. Nothing happened. Oh, wait, I think there's a guy I could talk to up there. Nothing happened. Yeah, there is a person I could talk to. Oh, it's a child! Oh, look at him, he's cute. Micah. I was right. There is dots on the arms. It's ears. Let's talk to him. Wow, that was just like the time the external fuel tanks exploded on re-entry. I'm not that bad, sir. I'm not that bad. be okay flying the big one, right? Say grr to this. I am totally good at life. I'm totally good at life. Wait, does he say different things if I do different things? Let's see. Okay, fly the model ship. You know, I want to go into the geyser. Let's see what happens if I put in the geyser. Oh, no. Nothing happened. Nothing happened. Let's try that again. Let's try that again. I got this. Into the geyser! Why am I going sideways? Well, apparently that's how I'm gonna use things now. Oh, wait. You can run out of gas in the little guy? See, look, I teleported him back before anything could happen to him. Off in the space I go. Heck. Alright, let's see what happens if I just send him into space. He almost died. No, I teleported him back before anything could happen. Let's put him into space again and see what happens. Oh god, I can't see, that sun is too bright. I can't see anything. Where'd he go? Let's reset and talk to the child. Oh. That's just the same message. Okay. Maybe I'll try to land on that planet up there. Let's try this again. Let's try this again. Didn't let me. Lame sauce. And I burned him as a murder method. It's 1,101. No, no. I'm trying to learn. Why for you tease me whilst I'm trying to learn? This is not how learning works. Let's try to. Why is he sideways? Okay, I swear, I have no idea what happened that time. Okay. Don't go sideways this time. Let's put you on this planet. I'll be the best at putting guys on planets here soon. Yes, onto the planet. Huh. I think I hit the planet. He exploded! No! I'm just trying. Where's the moon? I guess since I can't land him on the planets, I'll land him on the moon. There's a lot of things flying off of that one red little planet star thing. Where's the moon at? That is a moon right there, but not the moon for this planet, I don't think. He's dead. God, why are you guilt tripping me? Oh, well, I didn't mean to fly off into the distance there. The moon takes a bit. Lame. Oh, there it is. I see the moon. Okay, okay, let's try this. Let's try this. E. Why are you going sideways again? Come back. Reset. Alright. Let's not go sideways this time. Why are you only going sideways? What the heck was that? No. 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 Alright. Now where's the moon? I saw it this way. Where'd the moon go? Well, that was a firefly. Go there! Go there! Go there! Oh, he didn't. Oh no! He's running out of fuel in different tanks. Back to here. Alright, let's try. I'm a bad parent to the spaceship! How dare... Oh, I found it, and it's gone. Goodbye. Ooh, space station. I'm trying, guys. I'm seriously trying. What the heck? The Porsche. Yeah, you know what? I'm done. I am done. Nope. I'm done. Next try is the ship with actually me in it. Let's go. I want to jump on top of this guy too, though. Let's do it. You're not supposed to touch these. I do not condone my actions. Oh, I can't jump on there. That's lame. This jumping mechanic is interesting. There we go. I'm on this now. Heck. This jumping mechanic is gonna take me a little bit to get used to. Talk to the people. I have completed my goal. No, I want to go back in there. Oh, shoot. I got it. I'm good at this game. I know I'm dead screen. What do I press? I just pressed escape. Is that actually the... Alright guys, so that was my playthrough of Outer Wilds. What did you guys think? What did you guys think? I think it's an adorable little game. I feel like it needs to have... I feel like it has to have more content in it. Very much small amount of content. However... It's one of the joke endings. I love that. Escape. Wait, so I actually have to start a new expedition because of that? Oh my god. Well, when I put this on a video series, that's gonna be the end of episode one. I should have played this yesterday on, I should have played this on April Fool's Day. That would be the funniest stream ever. Just, yep, that's the end of stream. Goodbye. That belongs on the YouTube memes. Heck yeah. New expedition. Let's go. Oh, God. Let's wake up. Oh, lordy. I am so good at this game. So good at this game. I've talked to you already. Let's go talk to everybody up here. Oh, goodness. First half an hour and I already found one of the joke endings. Bring out the hat and got it. Hat has been got. Alright, now let's not go into the... Let's go, the hat. I feel like that one guy... Oh, lordy, what is it? On that one kid's show. The Dimmadome guy where his hat goes all the way off the screen. That's what I feel like when I'm wearing this hat. Of course, it's not as high up as that. However... Heckin' geyser took my life last time. You are cooking a strange red liquid. Let's see what you have to say. You have four eyeballs, but you are still very adorable. Porphy. Good soup. Heyo, hatchling. I hear you're leaving us to seek adventure amongst the stars. When you return, let you, me, and Kasan open up a bottle of the good stuff. I'm only seeking adventure amongst one star, actually. Other stars are far, or too far away. The good stuff is less delicious sap wine and more daunting digestive challenge. Part of me wants to say that, but I'm gonna be nice to the guy. Another metaphor ruined in the name of scientific accuracy. Nevertheless, I do hope you enjoy your travels. Good luck! Onto the barrel. Hello, dude. I don't really do stuff like that. No, thank you. Grr, indeed. Be gone, indeed. Can I go in here? No, that's fine. Okay. Hello! I love how they have, like, little weed faces. It's adorable. You're actually blasting off in that thing, huh? They really don't explode as often anymore. Oh, no. I'm told my odds of survival are statistically quite high. You know what? I'm gonna do that. They don't really explode as often anymore. All I know is between the space program and Mike's model rockets, things seem to burn to the ground around here more than they used to. Oof, Outer Wilds Ventures presents Postcards from Orbit. This projector is linked to our Sky Shutter satellite, which is currently orbiting Timber Hearth. The satellite is equipped with two onboard cameras. See if you can take a snapshot of our village. Let's see if I can find it, guys. We're just gonna go... Is that it? I got it! There it is! Heck yeah! Reed. The pilot seat used by pioneering astronaut Feldspar is all that remains of our inaugural flight into space. I got this, see? Although it's been argued, since a distraction requires a breathtakingly liberal definition of flight, that day will nevertheless always be remembered as a landmark achievement in Earthian history. Fair enough. Hello, pilot seat. It's a little museum. It's a little spaceship lad. This is a very darkly colored game, but it's very beautiful. Little water thing right there. I want to go into the geyser, then I know I'll die. Hello, Marl. You are tall. So it's launch day, huh? Alice, going to miss you. Speaking of launch day, I was thinking about it, and the platform those ships launch from is getting old. Isn't it about time you built a new, less flammable one? Oh no. That big tree in the village would be a perfect choice. I wouldn't mind helping out the space program, just say the word. The current launch pod is fine, thanks. Nice try, we all know you have it out for that tree. The launch pad is flammable? You didn't realize that? Don't worry, it's held up for all the launches so far. It'll definitely be fine for yours, probably. That's very nice to hear. Wait, can I just- I could just pick all of the options. I didn't realize that. Peace, death. What? No, I just think it's in the way and someone ought to chop it down, you know? Specifically me. Haha, you think this has to do with the time I fell out of it and broke my arm? That was when we were hatchlings. Who would hold a grudge for that long? That tree has got it coming. Oh no! If you swing by the moon, say hi to Esker for me. Oh, I can't select any more of the... That's lame. Marl. Alright, let's see what else you gotta say. Oh, you can just talk? Okay, I see how this works now. Are you going to watch the launch? Of course. I'll be watching from a safe distance, obviously. And mostly make sure nothing catches fire, but watching nonetheless. You really worry that the space program will burn the village down? Only constantly. You'll learn to live with it. You didn't know you could go back and forth between them? Yeah, apparently. You also learn to sleep with a bucket of water next to your bed just in case. Oh no. Marl is plotting to cut down that big tree again. I suppose it's my duty as mayor to stop them again. And Marl fell out of that tree and broke their arm. I suspect they may have also hit their head on the way down. Aww. Let's talk to this guy again. It's like one of the important things of the game. Yeah, no, I missed one of the options on him. I'm so mad now. Is it just with these specific characters? Ho, the astronaut returns. Tell me, what can I do for you? Any new dirt? I'm hoping to teach Esker to tap trees next time they return from the Atoll Rock. If they'll bring me a lunar sap, I can attempt moonwine. That's cool. What are you up to? I just finished sealing up another batch of sapwine for aging. I'd like to begin aging a batch on the day of a significant occasion, you know? That's why there are so many bottles. Labeled structure collapse and house fire. Oh, no. Well, if you've learned anything about this village, it's that everything likes to collapse, break, and start on fire, which is definitely encouraging for the fact that we're about to go into space. Oh, no. Okay, so that's all of their options. Let's see if there's any more lads over here. Oh! Hello! Gnis? We'll go with Gnis. I don't know how else to pronounce that. Hello there, Space Cadet. I hear you're leaving the crater today. If you meet any of the other travelers up there, remind them to take proper care of their instruments, won't you? You don't know how to say it either. Yeah, that's fair, Blue Jay. Solar, yes. I'll call you Solar Instrument. What's Blue Jay? Blue Jay, Solar Blue Jay. A sun, a big star that's in the shape of a Blue Jay. That would be cool. Okay, tell me about the travelers' instruments. Oh, sure. I made all their instruments, you know? Let me see. There's Chert's drums, Ryvek's banjo, and Gabbro's flute. I think Gabbro's a rock, by the way. Fun fact. And Feldspar is another rock. Feldspar's harmonica, of course, though Feldspar has been missing for a long time. Oh, no. Seems like it feels like just yesterday when they were playing their harmonica around the campfire. Anyway, you hear music in space. That'll be one of the space program's other travelers. That's good to know. If you feel like company, you can always pull out your signal scope and track them down. Trouble is, every time a Hearthian leaves for outer space, that's one less musician in our orchestra. Hello, Solaratoon, my new friend. So, did you need something? Tell me. Oh, where is the observatory? Oh, it's questions like that that make us worried about you going up to space on your own, you know. The observatory is up the path beyond the waterfall. There's a couple of signs marking the way, but really, you just keep going up and then hook a right when you get to the Zero G Cave. Fair enough, lady. Oh, I already talked to you once. Anything else I could find in this area? Hydrate? Oh, heck, I'm exploring. Let me do a hydrate. Just let me get to a place where we'll get lost. We'll watch Gnis play their guitar. I'll be right back. Meanwhile, the hat's just getting stuck all over my head. Here we go. Grab my headphones back off the floor. Oh, hey, Cereal. Are you in the are you in the Discord server? Oh, hello, Cereal. Are you in the language? Are you in the Discord server? There we go, I do about this much for hydrants. Heck yeah. I was just double checking. Alright, time to go to the observatory. I wonder where the Zero G cave is. I wanna go in there. Can I parkour up this? Woo! Let's go. I explore. Oh, nope, that's not what I wanted. Heck. Alright, let's see if there's anything up here. Oh, well, that's not good. Ouch. Looking around. Yeah, you can never leave the chat. You'll become a good friends and like to... Oh, that's nice. I'm glad to hear that. There's something up there. How do I get up there? There's like little things everywhere. I don't know if I could get up there. Well, maybe. Nope, that's not it. Uh-oh, did I just make myself stuck? Get unstuck. Get unstuck. Okay. Let's try this on the barrel. Ah, I can't get up there. Lame sus. Okay, let's go to the observatory now. I think Blue Jay's. Well, yum yum. Solar Blue Jay. Solar is there as well. Oh, you're back. You're grabbing your own water. Yeah, you know what? Fair enough. That's very valid. I'm trying to explore. Oh! Okay, so there's little signs everywhere. Blue Jay, heck yeah. I'm trying to interact with these people. So, the zero gravity, the zero G cave is somewhere around here. I just love how dark everything is. It's really pretty. Also, this still concerns me. Just that's a lot of fire. You have COVID, so you have to hydrate. Fair enough. Fair enough. It's another one of those. I kind of want to go in it, but I know exactly what happens if I do. I saw green smoke. Oh, is that you? What are you doing, sir? Talk to Arcos. Please. Hi, astronaut. You know the patch of ghost matter inside this fence? Gosen says it used to be bigger when they were hatchling, because ghost matter evaporates. It just takes a uber long time to go away. I hope there's no ghost matter in the village when I'm a grown-up. Ghost matter is awesome. That is a child. That is indeed a child. Ghost matter is super cool. It'll burn the heck out of you. You shouldn't be throwing rocks in there. Ghost matter is dangerous. You know, ghost matter is how Tektite lost their foot, right? That's terrifying. We'll go with that. You shouldn't be throwing rocks in there. Ghost matter is dangerous. Obviously. That's what makes it so awesome. Jeez, I'm not dumb enough to touch it. Ugh, you're such a grown-up. It's cool that little scouts can detect ghost matter and all, but what would be really cool is if the little scout could, like, shoot ghost matter at stuff. Oh, pew pew pew! You will dropkick it! Bruh. Bruh. I kind of want to jump in there. Weird. Danger! Inside this fence is a pocket of ghost matter, a strange and dangerous substance that's invisible to the naked eyes. The good news is that you can detect ghost matter with a camera. Moving through ghost matter is uniquely painful and probably will kill you. Don't complain to me if you hurt yourself fooling around, Hornfels. I want to touch it. I want to touch. Let's go. Let's touch it. What's this? Ooh, use camera. Oh, that's really. Oh, it even moves around. If I click fast enough, you could see like the. You could see like the animation it has. That's really cool that they actually animated the ghost matter. So, jump in the matter of ghosts will do. Okay. Jump on the rock? No. On the rock. Yes. Into the ghost matter! Oh no. Oh no. Out I go. That was spooky! Did you guys see how it like warped the screen and stuff? I'm doing it again. Let's do it again, that was satisfying. Let's go! Oh, shoot. Maybe I should not have done that again. Yep. I do see that. I'm gonna get an achievement for every single type of death that's achievable in this game. Does talking to people like help you proceed? Because I might not do that with how many times I'm dying. Alright, let's go. We're just gonna pretend that I haven't died to a geyser in ghost matter yet, because that just doesn't happen, you know? It's totally unheard of. Not in my history at all. Nope, nope, nope indeed. Let's not jump off of the cliff, because I don't need to die again. Because this game has fall damage. Let's go continue our adventure. I do want to go into the Zero-G cave, though. That's gonna be cool. Yes and no. Oh, what I meant was I'm not going to talk to the people I've already talked to. Because I've already talked to them. And I don't want to talk to them every single time, you know. Did I get to talk to you yet? No, I have not. Tephra. Talking to Tephra. Hello, astronaut. If it isn't my favorite troublemaker... What's with the radio? Let's go with this one first. We wanted to play hide and seek, but Moraine won't let us borrow their signal scope because it's really delicate and not supposed to be thrown around like that. Hey, can we use your signal scope? Can we, please? We'll even let you be it. Sure, let's play. Woohoo! Okay, here are the rules. Galena and me will hide with these radios, and you will use your signal scope to find us. Last one to be found wins. Okay, close your eyes and start counting. One. Two. Oh, that. Yep, counting to one. There we go. Press Y to equip. Oh, this is interesting. How the heck? Where is everybody? Okay. Too that I couldn't talk to. talk to Gilena. Aw. You found me. Alright, person two. Let's find the other kiddo now. Somewhere this way. Find the child. I have found the child. There's a nugget. Hello, nugget. All right. Hello, Spino. Fishing rhyme. Fishing rhyme. Singing Huntsman has the time. You're leaving the crater. Guess we'll all be a little busy without you around to lend a hand. Water is loud. Can you guys hear me? It is, but it's okay, okay. That big water planet, Giants Deep, that's where I'd go. Why is that? You can hear me, okay. One time, after the rest of the village had left to sleep, and it was just the two of us sitting around the campfire, Gabbro told me about their first trip to Giants Deep. They landed their ship easily enough in the waves, but couldn't see too far down. On account of how murky the water was, I guess too dark. Gabbro wants to see what lays beneath the surface, so they decided to travel deeper. They traveled down and down, but suddenly Gabbro couldn't go any further. Yeah, Giant Steve has a current you can't pass through. I underestimated how boring this would be. Goodbye. Oh, that's so mean. Tell me more. My chat and Twitch and your chat on screen is so slow. Yeah, that is a thing that happens sometimes. I have a little bit of a lag. Hands up, this is a robbery. Plus director is striking again. Hello. Why is this a robbery? You can see my hands up, but why? I don't have anything I can give you. I just started. Here. You can squish this internally in your soul, then that's what you can have. You have a large number of very tiny rocks. I also have rocks. This is mossy agate. This is mossy agate, and I love it. It's one of my favorites. It's really pretty. It looks kind of like a little earth. It has quartz in it, too. Summon and treat the doggo. I got it. Let's go. I got that. This guy can tell us more here in a second. Down the lad. Here he is. Here's the baby. He already smells it. All right. And there you go. Almost. Almost. You just made the screen go brighter. There you go. We have summoned and treated the baby. He says hello and he appreciates the goodies. Down you go. This is Outer Wilds. It's a game that Blue Jay, aka Solar, actually got for me. So I thought I would play it on stream. It's been pretty cute so far. And I see that we also have a hydrant. Also, thank you. Believe it or not, he's 17 years old. You do gotta go. I'm playing this 100% blind. I don't know anything about what's happening, dude. Let me... There we go. Double check. Oh! The text option I had on was, tell me more. I will. I was just pausing dramatically. As though exercising a will of its own, the water was refusing to let Gabriel go any deeper. It held Gabriel back, almost as if it was trying to protect them from something. And then, in the terrible darkness, Gabriel saw it. The tentacle of some hideous beast! Screams, is that all true? Was there sap wine involved during Gabriel's campfire story? Is that all true? Heard it from Gabriel themselves. Gabriel can be a little fanciful at sure, but they aren't a liar. I mean, probably anyway. I guess if you want to know if the story is entirely true, you can go see the Giant's Deep for yourself. I kind of want to. Alright, is there... Yeah, Pluto, you missed it. There was a joke death that I fell pack. I just... Back up. No. Heck. I went into that geyser down there. And this one right there. It's not going off right now, but apparently it was a joke death. I also got another one from standing in the ghosty goo matter, so... It's been interesting so far. I was also trying to land a little fake rocket on the moon, and the moon was too fast, and I just said, unless if you guys want me to try again, because I will try again if you want me to. The joke deaths are amazing. They are pretty funny. What's this? I haven't been here yet. Oh. Well, there's the ghosty goo matter. You can take pictures of it right here. It's kind of cool. Alright. Nope, wrong thing. There you go. Let's see what's up here. There's also a 0G cave that I'm trying to find. Use scout launcher. Let's read that paper first. Read. Northwest, Geyser Mountains. Okay. South, Quantum Grove Crater. Read. Nomai Ruins. Yongbark Crater. Oh, this is a way to travel to different locations. I don't know if I should do that yet. The 0G cave sign was by the waterfall. Oh. Let's go back down to the waterfall then. Did I complete my hydrate? Almost. There we go. Oh yeah, I was saying to go up here, wasn't it? Yeah, okay. Can I sprint? No, got it. Oh yeah, plus director. I invited you to join the Discord, correct? I think I did. I don't quite remember very well. 0G Cave! There it is. And there's a lad there too. Talk to Gusan. Gosan? Gosan. Hi! I thought I might see you before the big launch. Nerves getting the better of ya? Right. Like you weren't nervous for your first flight. I'm a little nervous, yeah. Are you kidding? I'm a natural. We're gonna go with this one. Good. Everyone should be a little bit nervous going into space. I got cocky during my first flight and nearly put a new crater in the moon. Oh, no. Oh, I just realized he's missing an eyeball. Hmm. Silly. Still, I was never as green as you. Hey, I've gotten better. Think so, do you? Feel like proving it to your old flight coach? There's a satellite, which is definitely not just a piece of broken mining equipment set up down in the zero-G cave and in need of repairs. If you're looking for a little last-minute zero-G practice, head down the lift and into the cave. Or don't, as so long as you're confident. You can make ship repairs in space. One repaired satellite coming up. Nah, I'm ready for the real deal. One repaired satellite coming up, indeed. Cool, get to it, and try not to concuss yourself right before you first launch. The way these characters are talking is not the most positive towards everything's gonna be... It's not really leaning towards everything's gonna be fine, you know, you got this. It's like, hey, you're gonna explode in a giant fiery plume of death, and I'm like, thanks, space alien man. That's totally what I want to hear right now. Oh, no. Ooh, pretty, though. F4 flashlight. Okay, this is a really pretty area, though. Zero-G cave. It seems like it has a lot of gravity. Oh, it does have less gravity. Fair enough. I wanted to take... Apparently I cannot, though. Yeah, it is really funny. I do definitely agree with the funniness of it. Zero-G cave is up. Suit up. Oh no.
Also, I'm so glad I got solo ult in my belt cosplay.
Oh no.
Again, gotta focus me.
Oh no, this is like how the spaceship was. Nope. Yep, okay, we got it. We didn't fly away. Is the zero G cave really scientifically accurate? I don't know why there would be a zero-G cave in real life, if that's what you're asking. That's a part of the elevator. There's a little pulley system. Zero-G cave is down there. Well, I want to talk to the other guy that's over here first. Outer Wilds Venture. Hello, Tuff. Tuff is also a type of rock. Hey, nice of you to drop down. I'm getting some zero-G time in. Give me the dirt. Oh? Guess where I'm going today. Give me the dirt first. Some fresh dirt, not much happening down here lately. Let me think. Come to think of it, Takite saw something crash outside of the village crater earlier. That's new and different. Oh, hey, how about that? Is anything on fire? Probably only a little. Tektite, which is also a rock, checked out the crash site with the old Firewatch scout. Oh, the Firewatch scout launcher and saw smoke, so they headed over to stamp any leftover fires. Well, I better get back to work. This ore's not going to mine itself, you know. I want to talk to you still. Guess where I'm going today? Oh, no. No. No, no, no. No way. You want to run off into space. That's your business. But don't make me, you know, think about it. Bad enough. We've got this weird cave down here. Just getting some zero-G time in. So you're going in there? In the cave? What? No, I'm fine. Great and fine. You don't look fine. I'm gonna drift around down there for a little bit. You don't look fine. Well, you know that I hate that cave, so I don't know why you're making me talk about it. Ugh. Now I've got the hand sweats. I'm still talking to you, sir. Yeah, I'm gonna drift around there for a while. Just gonna float upside down and whatnot. Just, you know, ricochet off the walls, spin around a lot, that kind of thing. You're the worst. I know. I love that. I love that. Is there any other people in here? No, but the cave is down there. Let's jump right here and see where we're at. Okay, cool. Is anything cool over here? No? Okay. How about over here? Ow.
Bean?
Bean?
Did you happen to feed Spirit or no?
No. Oh wait, I forgot to check if my camera's still okay. My camera is still okay, cool. I'm trying to find, like, cool things. Because I want to find every single Easter egg in this game that I can. Is it a long one? Oh no. That's spooky looking down there. You know, usually when something has red lights, that means don't mess with it. But you know what? Heck it. We went into the heckin', ghost thing. Oh no. We went into the ghost thing. Repair this. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, hello, Fonzo. I'm currently in a zero-G cave trying to figure out how the heck to Oh, there's another one, apparently. Lock on and match velocity. Let's go and match velocity. Just a little bit more forward. And there we go. I can fix this now. This is a really cute game. It's really funny. This looks like a horror film. Yeah, I don't... Yeah, you happen to come on a creepy part. Usually red lights mean don't. But this is a... Heck, go back this way. Lock on. This way. Some of it's really funny. Don't run into things. I don't want a concussion, as that guy warned me. Match velocity. And repair. There we go. Training simulation completed. Now, what's that down there? Oh, wait, no, that's not down. That's up. And I hit a wall. Oh, lordy. Yeah, you know what? Let's just, yeah, we'll go back up towards how up thrust. No, too fast, too fast. Go down. Crap, nothing happened. Nothing happened. You were afraid of space. Well, this is a cute space game, my friend. Can I go up? Velocity matched. 33 repair training. Yes, training simulation is complete. Space is really cool. All right, there we go. That's how we go up. All right, let me down. Wait, no, I need to go up still. Keep putting me up. But bye? Aw, okay. That's understandable. Oh, no! Don't die! Oh, lordy. Okay, we're good. We're good. We're good. Why? Right now, we're running around and talking to cute alien people. It's very funny. It's not very wholesome, because we're talking about everything falling and exploding. But, it is a silly, goofy place. Up we go! Out of the zero gravity cave. It takes forever. Also, I have spots on my hands. I find that hilarious. But yeah, there's a little guy. You could snort that rock dust. I don't want to snort the rock dust, bro. Nicely done. Of course, it'll be a little more stressful when you're hurtling through space. But remember, you're training, and try not to hit anything big. I can see you're itching to get off this rock, so go get the launch codes from the observatory and get out of here already. Yeah, you know what? I see how it is. Right? Aren't they so adorable? Because it doesn't matter which way you're facing. There's no up or down, left or right. Everything is gas and fire, endless, yet completely whole. Yeah! Yeah, you're not wrong! I wonder if that was the core of this planet. Yeah, see, that's why you're scared of space. Yeah, you know, I get lost so easily already. I get lost everywhere. So, yeah, no, this is gonna be interesting, seeing how I am when there's no up or down. Best of luck out there. And hey, try to avoid getting yourself killed now that I've put so much training into you. Got it? Wow, I see how it is, bro. Okay, Gossan. Goodbye, sir. Wow. Also, here's that ghost stuff. I just had to. Okay. What's the opposite of claustrophobic with that? You know what? That's definitely fair. Ooh, I kinda wanna go down there. I'm not going to. Unless if you guys really want me to go down there. But also, why wouldn't you want to get lost in space? There's so much to do, little that it doesn't matter where you go. Oh my god. Waterfall. Oh, yeah. It is very loud. I forgot about that. The waterfall is super loud. There's also geysers that are really loud. Oh. Hello, Moraine. Hmm? Oh, hello, astronaut. This is good weather for your lunch, right? That's lucky. What are you up to? I'm using my signal scope to pick up sounds from distant planets. Let's set the Outer Worlds Ventures frequency so I can pick up the Traveler's music. Last night I heard Rybeck's banjo coming from Brittle Hollow. I hope that means they're safe. I can hear different planets, too. It depends on what time of day or night it is, since different planets are in the sky at different times. Signal scopes are cool. I agree. Let's talk to Moraine. Any good sounds from space today? There are! My signal scope is sent to the Outer Wilds Ventures frequency, so I'm listening to the Traveler's music. Last night I heard Rybeck's banjo coming. Oh, yep. 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 Okay. Equipped signal scope. I just flashbanged my soul. Oh, I am missing stuff. What's happening? It does have scrolls. The sun. Yeah, it does have scrolls. Oh. That's their frequency. I wonder if I'd be able to see another person's frequency from here. It sings! The bag sings. It does. Scrolls. Oh, wait, no, that's a planet behind us? Aw, oh, that's lame. I was about to get excited, just like, yo! Aw, oh, there's no frequency on the planet. Where's another planet I can look at? Oh, there's one. That's an interesting sound. You're sad now? No! Singing scrolls. You will never recover. Aww. Ooh, look at those little constellations. Okay, what should we name this constellation? What should we name this constellation? What does it look like? It looks like a tiny dipper. This one should be square. This one's also a square. Why are there so many squares? That's lame. Are there any other ones that we can look at? That one's big, but it's also mostly covered by a triangle. Yeah, we should name that one triangle. I agree. What about this one? Oh! Oh! I just saw something fall from this. Should I be concerned about that? There are some actual constellations. Oh, cool. Like, this one looks kind of like a circle, in a way. Spiral. Where's all the planets? There was like 8 planets floating above here earlier. What is this? It's called lame sauce. That's what it's called. Okay, let's go continue. Oh, there are some actual constellations? I am so... What's on the moon? Somebody's whistling. What's that? Oh, it's a spaceship. On the moon. I love how music themed this is. Oh, hello. How do I pronounce your name? Oak. I will call you Oak. Hello, Oak. It is a nice rock, isn't it? I like it. It makes music. Shade or Zade? Okay. Zade. We'll go with Zade. Or Oak. Okay, fair enough. Oh yeah, we need to put that down now so that there's not just buzzing in my ear. It's my long-lost son on the moon! Oh lordy, do I have children? Well, there's a child. The sun. Oh, hello, my friend Photo! Catch him? How am I supposed to catch and contain the child? Oh my lordy. He's throwing stuff at Ghost Matter right now. With a big butterfly net? I don't have a big butterfly net. I have a thing that shows me when rocks are singing to me, bro. That's another thing falling from the sky. I bet that's the observatory we're supposed to be going to. Make one! Trap him like a cat. Oh lordy, guys. Fonzo and Blue Jay, you two. Apparently there's a planet on the other side of that. Where'd it go? There it is. The sun makes music? Who's on the sun? Somebody's on the sun. There we go. Flashbang everybody. I flashbang myself too, but worth it. There's somebody on the sun. I do love that banjo. I think I mentioned that somebody does have the banjo. Prob landed there at night. Yeah. I don't know if that's how it works, my dear friend. The sun is a giant banjo confirmed. Heck yeah. Also, yes, I agree. I also murdered my eyes at that point, so let's not do that. Oh, it's the moon again. I'm gonna start to memorize what each of the planets are. We're gonna give them made-up names, and it's going to correlate to the music, and that's how we're gonna remember which one's which, okay? Oh, this is a cute little spot. Alright, how the heck is that the thing that I'm supposed to go? The government didn't want us to know about the singing rocks. I love that. Ooh, it's a museum. Oh, look at that. Hornfels? Gossen, Feldspar, Esker, and Slate. All of the names of the little alien dudes are rocks, and I love that. This is a very geological game. Big thanks to these additional founding members of the Outer Wilds Ventures, without whom we would never have gotten off the ground. Matthew Steinhauer. Oh, it's special thanks to people for making the game. Ben Etherington. QWERTY-YWOP the pie. Jordan Frith, Tom Cummings, Sean Shark Templar Farrell, Stephen Ursell, Ryan Omrecker, heck yeah. You and the boys, they are all Yoda X Dobby. Oh, why would you say that? You've ruined this. Bruh, why would you do this? Here, Hal, let's see what you're talking about. Hey, it's my favorite astronaut. Lunch day at last, huh, buddy? It's the Translator Tools Inaugural Flight Tool 2. I'm so excited, it's making me nauseous. That's not good, sir. Just think, you'll be able to translate any no-mind text you want, anywhere you are. The two of us put a lot of hours into inventing that tool, so don't break it, okay? Ugh, jeez, do not break it. Ignore me, okay? I'm just nervous. And I'm not even the one going into space. How are you feeling? Based on how everybody's talking about me and exploding and dying, I'm terrified. All of me wants to say that I'm excited, though. You keep thinking about how the top eyes blinking brows? Are you saying that they're blinking eyebrows? The top eyes are bro. What, eyebrows don't blink, and that's disturbing. Imagine if eyebrows did blink. What the heck would that what would that even look like? What would that look like? You wish you knew how to make your eyebrows look like eyes. I mean, you probably could. You'd probably just put some glue on top of your eyebrows, paint it with foundation, paint it white, and then put an eyeball in the center of it. I mean, I don't like the thought of that, though. Or his bottom eyes are large nostrils. You can see, you can clearly see the nostrils in between the bottom eyes, Fawn, so why? Well, but I'm excited. Good. You've only been waiting for this day since we were hatchlings. I can't wait to see you, all your training pay off. So what's the dirt? You here to see the new Nomai statue? Just shave him, put googly eyes. Oh no. Am old man, oh lordy. You're not allowed to say that, Fonzo. Pirate Dobby Yoda. Somebody needs to, like, make a meme of that and then put no context. Just say, Pirate Dobby Yoda. And then that'll be the whole meme. That'll be perfect. Okay. New statue. You haven't heard? Gabbro brought it back with them from the Giant's Deep, and Hornfels just finished preparing it for display. This is it, right here. Neat, huh? I can't look at it! My screen is locked. Makes me wish we could see what real-life Nomai looks like. But I guess this is as close as we'll ever get. Check it out. Looks like they had fur. Fur is weird. I guess these guys don't really have hair, so I do... That does make sense that they would think that fur is weird. No, that was a drawing prompt for these guys. Fur is weird. Oh lordy, here goes Fonzo on one of his other cursed with extra body parts things over there. I guess you've already been doing that though, haven't you? Heckin' eyebrow eyeballs. To spam the Discord with eyebrow eyeballs and confuse everybody. Fonzo, are you bald? I don't think you're bald. You have no hair? Huh. Just grow some fur. Yeah, as Blue Jay said, grow some fur, my friend. You will no longer be bald if you have fur. Fur is weird. Fair enough, Fonzo. Makes me wish we could see... Right, I read that. This is the first fully intact statue ever found, you know. And for how old it is, it's in great shape. Ah, jeez, I got a little carried away there. Go on, you have your ship to launch. Take care of yourself out there, you hear? You have no skin. Fonzo, no. You are jelly. No skin, no fur, just jelly, as Blue Jay says. Fonzo, are you just a little... Wait. Are you telling me that this whole time you've just been this little glop of slime just living in somebody's basement? Well, you'd have to have eyeballs in order to watch a stream. I mean, if anything, to type, you wouldn't need hands. You could just grab little goo tendrils and just type on the keyboard. Jelly skin. You live in a jar. I see, but then how do you type? That's the question. How do you type? This is the statue. It does look like he has fur. That's a cool-looking statue, though. Let's read this text. This remarkably intact statue is carved by the Nomai, an ancient species who dwelled in our solar system thousands of years ago. You can grow fingers at will. Fair enough, Fonzo. Handy, but beautiful, I love that pun. The statue provides us with our most detailed look yet at the Nomai, who appear to have been covered with a layer of fur. Note the decorative jewelry that has been carved as a part of their antlers. Although their artifacts and structures have been found on almost every planet in the solar system, we still have no idea where this species came from or what happened to them. Oh. Well, that's spooky. I bet that has something to do with the plot of this game. This piece of Nomai writing was essential to deciphering their unique language. Hey! Alien version of the Rosetta Stone! Although this text is linear, Nomai text often branches off from a central point. Interesting, each branch tends to be written by a different author. Huh. Coming soon. Future site of our next exhibit. If you've enjoyed our time with Outer Wilds, please consider supporting our planned museum expansion. Our quest is to explore the furthest reaches of our solar system. Wouldn't be possible without generous visitors like you. We thank you profusely for your support, and we hope to see you again soon. That's nice. That's lovely. Oh, planets! That is a cool planet! Look at this guy! Okay, imagine if we had a planet in this... That's the DLC? Oh, fair enough. There's DLC for this game. Awesome. Stars like our sun generate light and heat by fusing hydrogen into helium. As it grows older, the star runs out of hydrogen and starts to contract. Fair enough. As the star's core contracts... Oh, it's a diagram of how stars work. Okay. As the star's core contracts, it gets hotter, causing the outer layers to expand. The star has become a red giant. When the core is hot enough, it starts to fuse helium into carbon. If the star is massive enough, it'll continue to fuse carbon into even heavier elements like iron. Ultimately, the star will collapse under its own gravity and then explode in a violent event called a supernova. I want to see a video of a supernova. That would be epic. Based on Chert's observations, this will one day be the fate of our own sun. Yep, that's actually real for real life, too. That's kind of cool looking. This crystal was taken from a Nomai ruin on Brittle Hollow. It seems to create a local gravity distortion and was most likely used to traverse steep surfaces. Try it out! I'm on a wall, guys! Oh, God, that's weird. Well, shoot. It puts me on the wall. I love that. That's so weird. I don't know how I feel about that, actually. Okay, yep, we're done. Which way is the floor again? Please put me on the floor. Here, let's just run away from that. Okay, whoa. Blue Jay, are you having me play a spooky game? Because I am pretty dang sure that that's a spooky alien that's gonna end up eating my face. Is this a horror game? I am not prepared for a horror game. A puppy? Blue Jay, no. Fonzo, what is your opinion on that? Nope, no worries. Okay. Worried. Alright, let's read this. This anglerfish specimen was found attached to the landing gear of one of our ships that flew close to Dark Bramble. It appears well suited to living in dark places with minimal atmosphere. This is not a dark place for the fish. Okay. Oh, I already read that. Oh, look at the little ship lad. Little ship lad, I love that. Is there any? There is writing right here. The Nomai technology brought back from space by our astronauts has been a great boon to our Outer Wilds ventures, allowing us to modify expedition gear in exciting and useful ways. For example, this little scout now boasts a warp retrieval capability that allows astronauts to recall their scouts almost instantly. This has been dramatically reduced the number of scouts lost to the depths of space. That's good. Oh, that is a skeleton of something that could possibly be spooky. What you see here are parts of a Nomai skeleton. We can tell from their skulls that they possessed antlers and quite usually only three eyes. Only! The Nomai body was most likely adapted for living exclusively on land. The differences in the Nomai's anatomy, such as their shockingly fragile bone structure, show us that Herthians couldn't have descended from Nomai's ancestors. It's not clear where the Nomai originated from or why they disappeared. We hope to find more clues to this puzzle before we explore our solar system. Fair enough. And this. Aside from the dwellings and structures they built, the Nomai also made art. This decorated pottery was discovered on Brittle Hollow. Some ancient Nomai art depicts strange animals, foreign celestial objects, and other subjects that can't be found in our solar system, which makes us wonder whether the Nomai originated elsewhere in the universe or simply had vibrant imaginations. Were the Nomai born in our solar system, or were they born among other stars and planets? And if they were, how and why did they come here? These are just some of the questions we hope to answer through further xenoarchaeological expeditions. I said that word! Beautiful. Said a word, guys. What's this? Oh, it's a little thing of balls. Can I interact with it? No, that's lame. What's this? Watch closely. These balls move on their own. The ground is perfectly level, so what do you think causes the spooky motion? Oh shit, they do move on their own! The answer is the moon. As it orbits around our planet, the Atoll Rock's gravity pulls on objects from different directions. In fact, it's pulling on you right now. I don't know how I feel about that. Slowly rotating. That's kind of cool. Let's go upstairs and see what else we can learn about this place. A little observatory. I want to use the big telescope. That's lame. You can translate the I'm going back down. I want to translate the writing on the rock. Let's go. Science for the win. I'm lazy. We're jumping off the side of that. Oh, and there's a thing I missed. Okay, we'll translate this. Translate. Wait, let's start at the top. Oh, no. Okay. We're nearly ready. Felix and I have finished construction, and she says calibrating the device won't take long. Fortunately, the Atoll Rock's lack of atmosphere will make calibration simple. After all this time, I'm thrilled to finally resume our search. That's not a thing. That's really cool that you can do that. What did I... No, I was in there already. I've been there. Oh! This. Okay. That's kind of an interesting looking statue. Read. Strange rock moving around in this grotto appears to react to conscious observation. The level-headed among us realized there must be some sort of optical illusion at play, but Gabriel claims the rock exists in all possible states until it's observed, whatever that means. Whatever is actually happening, both sides of this debate agree the effect is extremely creepy. I agree that that is indeed creepy. It's a rock that moves. Yeah, you know what? No, thank you. We're just not gonna with that. Are we gonna... Well, I don't want to ask, but I swear to goodness, if there's a planet that you look at and then you look away and then it just immediately disappears, I am not gonna know what to think about it. What happens if you're on that planet when that happens? Oh, hello, Hornfels. There you are, I just finished pre-flight observations, and local conditions are good. Time to get our newest astronaut off the ground. Sorry, there's something on my screen. Let me fix that really quick. What is that? Oh. It was some mac and cheese from when I was eating mac and cheese on stream. And it accidentally fell. And you'll be our first astronaut ever equipped with a Nomai translator too. I'll confess, I've been giddy all day just thinking about it. We're better equipped than ever to unravel the mysteries of the Nomai. You and Hal should be very proud of your work. Tell me, what is your plan once you're in space? Am I going to learn more about the Nomai, meet up with other travelers? I want to go somewhere that no one's gone before. They'll think I'll start with something small. Oh no, I'm gonna wing it. What do you think I should say? What should I do? Learn more about the Nomai? Meet up with other travelers? Go somewhere nobody's gone before? Or something small, or winging it? Like, what do you guys think? Wing it? Okay, we'll wing it. Planning to follow in the footsteps of Feldspar and the Great Other Wild Ventures tradition, are you? I might have guessed. Well, see if you can't put that translator tool of yours to good use while you're out there. Well then, it looks like all that's left is to send you off. All in all, it's a fine day for a lunch. I'm ready to die in space. I'm ready to die in space. Wow, that's a nice way to put that. Let's say I'm ready to get off this rock. Excellent. You'll be needing the launch codes then. Here they are. Best get off the ground before Slate makes any more modifications to your ship, eh? Mega Dong Dong Energy. Wing it. Big confidence. Big confidence indeed. Good luck out there. Let me know if I can help you with anything. Oh, it's Morse code on the bottom there. I need to read what you guys were saying about the rocks. Singing rocks, rocks that think rocks are gonna take over the world. I mean, everybody's already named after rocks, though.
Are you okay?
Wait, hold on.
We don't talk about rocks.
Oh, hey, guys.
Hello, we're here for movie night.
You're here for movie night?
Yep.
All right.
What are you playing?
I'm currently streaming.
What you playing?
My friendos are here, guys.
Oh, you're playing the new game, yeah.
What new game? What you playing?
I'm currently playing Outer Wilds. Blue Jay got it for me. This is steampunk. I stream with steampunk sometimes. You know them from Toontown. What? Don't be flipping people off on my stream.
Listen, steampunk let me off twice in the car.
I'm sorry, Mom.
Yeah.
Oh, my lordy. Blue Jay says hello.
Hello.
Fonzo also says hello.
We don't talk about Bruno. No.
Ice cream is melting. My ice cream!
Okay.
How's the game going?
The game's going great. It's really cute. Fonzo says no.
Hi, Fonzo. No, you. Uno reverse.
No, please.
Do you have any that song's gonna be stuck down in here.
What?
Do you have any spoons down here?
No. If ooh, that's that. You guys have dots. Go upstairs. There's stuff. There's dishes upstairs. There's no dishes up down here.
Fonzo says don't talk.
I have younger siblings. Don't talk to. Do not with the Encanto. Okay, no Encanto, guys.
Encanto.
No, Aaron.
I've never watched it.
It's good.
Fair enough.
It is a great movie.
Okay, let us keep going.
Is there dinosaurs in this
game? Is there dinosaurs? No, but there's this snow place, says Fonzo. Blue Jay agrees. No, but there's this weird little guy right here that makes no sense whatsoever.
He reminds me of like those deep sea fishes.
The anglerfish, yeah. They call it an anglerfish in game. Also, apparently you can walk on walls. I don't like it.
That's amazing. Is it zero gravity?
There is a zero gravity cage. That's not the floor. Let me off of the wall. Cute fishy. It is. It's kind of cute in a very scary way. You would pet it. You disagree with petting it?
I want to pet it.
Okay, everybody's agreeing with petting the fish, apparently.
Sweet puppy.
I'm stroking it with the cursor.
Can we name him Megalodon?
His name is Megalodon. Meggy the Megalodon. Let's go, anglerfish guy. You want to give it a little snack? Fair enough. Also, this rock moves when you look at it.
What? At least it's nothing like SCP-173.
Oh, lordy. Alright. Give him googly eyes. Yeah, if you give him googly eyes, that's the least scary thing you could do to that scary little lad right there. Oh shit. Wait, where am I? Oh no, I'm lost. Okay, there we go. Perfect.
Why are you looking at me?
Huh? Excuse me? What is happening?
Did you look into the eyes?
Excuse me?
It's a goat. The goat.
That was not sus at all.
Story question mark?
Let's go, it begins. Apparently, goodbye, creepy statue man with fur. Let's go to infinity and beyond. Heck yeah, let's go. Oh, hello, sir.
After your stream, you should teach me how to put tags on my stream.
Put what?
Put tags on my stream. After your stream, you should teach me.
Yeah, I can do that.
Yeah, because I need to do that. Okay. Plus, when I stream, I'm going to pop it in the garden so people will actually watch me.
Heck yeah.
Yay.
There is a huge story. Fair enough. Hey, so did you get a good look at the Nomai statue? Yes, it looked at me more than I looked at it. Statue was glowing. Why was it glowing? The statue looked at me and opened its eyes. There we go, why is it glowing? Whoa, the statue was doing what? So its eyes opened, and then you saw images from your own memories and glowing lights flying around. You mean like a hallucination? Listen, no offense, but are you sure you're okay to launch, like, medically speaking? You know what? Don't worry about it. No, that statue was definitely weird. I mean, if you're saying it happened, then I guess maybe it did, but why? Hornfels tried everything to get the statue's eyes to open, and nothing like this has never happened to them. I don't think you're going to get any answers from the museum statue, but Gabbro said they were going back to Giant's Deep. Don't know which island they're on, though. Maybe they'd be able to tell you more? On the other hand, Gabbro. So maybe you'd be better off searching for more info on your own. Jeez, I'm really jealous you're going into space. Hey, if you can use our translator tool to find out more about the statue, okay? See if you can.
Right?
Yeah, everybody just came out through the back door, which is why I didn't expect anything. Movie night starts in like an hour and a half, so. Good luck and safe flying! Alright, Hal, thank you. Guys!
What are you doing behind me?
Frozen pizza!
Oh, yeah, frozen pizza, okay. A huge story. Yeah, no, I'm really excited to see where this goes. Hello, cereal! Yeah, no worries, my dude. My phone just randomly... oh my god. Back when I used my phone as internet for my streams... Hey, guys, can you be a little bit... just a tiny bit more quiet when I am trying to... Why?
I will interrupt your stream as much as possible.
Why?
Can I put my saxophone instead?
What?
Can I put my saxophone instead?
No saxophone right now. I'm in the middle playing a video game!
Bruh.
Okay, fine, then I'm a loser then. Alright, let's go to the ship. Let's go back to the ship, alright? 10 out of 10 existence here. Let me check something just really fast.
I've called twice yesterday.
Okay.
Called where?
I'm gonna be right back here in one momento. Chaos came directly to my house, and now there's water everywhere. My goodness. This is effective on steroids. All right. All right, let us go into space. Enter launch code. Oh, it didn't actually have me launch the launch code. Okay. Ooh, it's a new ship. Ooh, it's a bunch of planets. Wait, hold on.
I have news.
That's an interesting sound. I like that one. Alright. I want to know the planet behind it. Nothing on that one. Oh, it's the same one. Oh, wow, they're connected. Oh, there's the moon again. Ooh, look at that, though. That's pretty. Okay. Into the ship! I've been abducted into my own ship. Alright. Ooh, you can actually run around inside of the ship? I love that. View ship log. View entries. The one and only Hearthian village, as well as the main source of explosions on this planet. Yeah! The Nomai statue in this observatory opened its eyes and looked at me. I saw the strange glowing lights and my own memories flashed before my eyes. Hal says the statue has never opened its eyes before, despite Hornfell's best efforts. Zero G Cave, a cave at the very center of Timber Hearth, used by Outer Wilds Ventures to train new astronauts. I successfully repaired another satellite for Gosan. Lunar Ruins. The Nomai text in the observatory talks about calibrating some sort of device on the Atoll Rock. I like the moon better. Q. No. Q. Okay, is there anything else over here? Ooh, it's a map, though. Dark Bramble. That looks interesting. I wonder if I'm gonna end up there at some point. Probably. Oh, it's one of those things that you used to walk on walls in there. Oh, lordy. Yeah, so, and then there's the suit, so I can suit up. Weapons? No. Oh, health kit. Little space guy. Alright. Let us lift off. We are ready to... Well, wait. Let me check one more thing really quickly. One more thing really quickly. You see? Alright.
Okay,
resume.
Can we get a large...
Now what? Oh, lift off. Landing carrier. Okay. C.
We'll try to just whatever is standard. Yeah.
Hold left shift. Oh no. Oh no! I'm falling back to the planet. We don't want to do that. Yeah, up we go. Up we go. Oh no! I forgot. Oh no! What's happening? Where am I? This is not good. Oh shit. Okay. Yep. Up. Haha! I'm good at this. All right. Am I far enough from the planet now?
That's everything.
Okay. We live! Now let's not crash into any of the planets. Where do I want to go? Well, there's the moon. You're fine. Yeah. Ooh, what's this? Is that a little... Let's go this way. I'm gonna get lost from the main planet. I swear to goodness. Oh, that's the Dark Bramble. Let's not go to the Dark Bramble. Space. Ah! Ooh, that's kind of a cool. I'm going to call that the Flower Cluster. It also has the banjo. Go on the banjo. This one? Oh, shoot. The Bramble's right next to me. What? Which one? Not the Dark Bramble. What one do I go on? The green one. Stage one, aligning flight trajectory, returning to solar system. Thank you. No, the sun banjo. You want me to go into the sun? I don't want to go into the sun. The big green planet with random lights. This one. No, don't do it. Why am I firing those rockets? I want to go to this one. Am I missing something? Oh, lordy. Where is life? Autopilot completed. This one. No, wait. Where'd it go? Oh, no, I lost myself. In space, there's no friction. Yeah. No friction exists except for when I rub my hands together. Then it becomes hot. Where the heck? Oh, this one. Right here. Let's go. Lock on. Giant's Deep. Are we wanting to go to Giant's Deep then? It looks like there's explosions happening on Giant's Deep. You gotta decelerate hours to keep your speed. Yeah, have fun. Okay. We'll go to this one. That is my jelly beans, not my hydrate. Let me land on the planet, please. Ooh, that's kind of cool. Bring me back. Bring me back. Please, I'm holding the forward arrow because I want to go this way. Can I land on this planet? Let me land on the planet. Can I go back? How do I land on the planets? That's not what I wanted. Bring me back. Retrieve the scout, please. Okay. Put scout onto the... Launch scout. Oh, it takes pictures. Retrieve scout. Remember what you said about friction? Yes, yes, yes. Use space to match velocity. Lock onto this. Let's go back. Go back. I'm good at this, guys. This is gonna go great. Okay. And then when I'm close enough to it, then I can match velocity. That's kind of close. There we go. Match velocity. Uh-oh. That's not good. Yep. There I go. There I go. No, go back, please. Go back. Go back. Go back. Back. Please. And then match velocity. Hello. Oh, thank you for the meal. Okay, now launch scout onto planet. Take pictures. I'm just watching it get closer and closer to that planet. What? Oh, it looks like water. We landed into some water. It looks like that planet is completely made out of water. Okay. You've seen way worse. Straight into the sun and stuff. Yeah, you know what? Fair enough. I don't know if I can make it onto that island. How do I land on this island? Island, planet. How do I land on the planet? Suicide Squad is Meanwhile, you can hear my partner talking in the background. Just go in, I'll be fine. Start flying right into it. Alright. I believe in Steve. Okay, but stop. Okay. Stop accelerating and drift for a bit. I'm slowing down. Do you want me to match velocity? Is that how I do it? Oh, I can't. Oh! Whoa! Ho, 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 ho! Up, 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 up! Holy cow! Oh! Not there! Not there! Not there! Not there! Not there! Not there! Oh, ho, 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 ho! No, 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 no! Velocity matched. Am I landing? Ah. Ho. Ooh, a little bit of a planet. How do I land? I want to land on this. Can I not? Ho! Nope, I don't want to leave the planet. I don't want to leave the planet. Put me back on the planet. Not in the... This is a terrifying planet. Why did you guys want me to go here? Where do I even land? Oh, that's where I land. I made it. I lived. I lived. That's terrifying. The tornadoes are terrifying. But I did it. 10 out of 10. Success. Heck yeah. Okay. Now, how do I get out of here? Q. Unbuckle. That's terrifying right there. Okay. Oxygen refill. Spot a tree, walk towards it, enjoy. Okay, that's good to know. 10 out of 10, no ship damage. Hey, heck yeah. Alright, let's suit up because I don't. Do we need a suit here? I don't know if we need a. Whoa. Gravity 2.8. Fuel and oxygen. How do I refuel this? Open hatch. This is spooky, isn't it? Do I need? I guess we can just go out there and see if I need it. Ow. Why did I take damage? Oh! I did need the suit. Back on the main island. Lame sus. Well, we're gonna take that as a moment for me to say, hey guys, I have a Discord. Heck, if you want to see more things, go here. This is a place where we send memes about cats and other cute things, so do it. It's great. It's fun. We totally don't talk about tentacle teeth. Fonzo! Okay. Let's try this again, okay? We'll try this again. Oh, hold up. You're going to want to get the launch codes from the observatory first. I already got them from the observatory, remember? Wait. Hold on. I have so many questions. The game is aware. The people are self-aware. Revival arc, let's go. I already got them from the observatory, remember? How did I get back here? Didn't I already left death? Wait, did I just die? What option should I choose, guys? What option should I choose? What should my character say in this unusual circumstance of glowing freaking goat eyeballs and revival from death because I am an idiot who doesn't put their suit on when I probably should? What should I say? What should I say? No. Did you have a bad dream or something? Oh, hello, Kataria! How are you doing, my dude? You can't stay for long, but you thought you'd just pop in and say hi. You know, fair enough. Fair enough. It's great to hear from you. It's been a little bit, I think. I won't ask how you got the code, so hurry up and launch before Hohenfels decides to ground you for medical reasons. I want to see whether the new cockpit stays attached during liftoff. It does. Doing well. How about you? I'm doing all right, too. This game is terrifying, and I'm very confused, and I'm gonna go into space again and not die this time. And see hallucinations of creepy goat statues. Alright, let's try this again. Buckle up. Let's go! Lift off into space! And we won't tumble back to the Earth 8,000 million times again. Alright. I am floating away from the planet, right? Yes. Back this way. Slow myself down. Okay, where is... There we go. Let's lock onto this planet and we're going back to the Giant's Deep. Let's not go in the sun, actually. No, get far away from that. Yeah, you know what? We're just not going to be locked onto that anymore. Let's go around the sun. We'll go around the sun. Outer Wilds, yeah. You don't think you've heard of this one. How do I like it? It is... I don't want to say hi. Well, ooh, look at the solar flares! Beautiful! Actually, you know what? Let's equalize with the sun here. And let's equip the scout launcher. We're gonna launch a scout. Take picture. This doesn't feel effective. Retrieve the scout. Yeah, no, it's really funny. It's really funny so far. Basically, yeah, we just woke up on an island. We're a little space astronaut dude with a bunch of aliens with four eyeballs, and all of a sudden this ancient statue decided to look into our soul and look into our brain, and then all of a sudden I just didn't die for some reason. So now, here I am, just kind of going in space, going to this scary death planet that people want me to go to, which is fine. Totally fine. Totally didn't almost run into 5 heckin' tornadoes at the same time, but we're going to ignore that because we got this. We're doing good, despite everybody telling us that we're gonna explode. It's great. We're doing great. Can I please get onto the planet, dude? Please? Equalize with planet first, because I am just not going towards this planet. Please. Go to planet. I can do it. I've done this once already. Oh yes, have fun at the scary death planet. Why does it feel like I'm going further and further away from this planet? I am pressing the forward button. Go forward, sir. Forward. Well, I'm starting to see the little storms on it now. Six hundred meters a second. So I am quickly speeding up. It's still 20 miles, 19 miles away. Okay, so I'm very quickly getting closer now. Let's just drift a little bit. Oh, I need to slow down. No, don't take me away from the planet, please. I want to go towards the planet. Come on, back. back to the planet. Stop going further away from the planet. No, this isn't what I wanted. Go back. Go back. Why am I still going further away from the second planet? Okay, I'm going back forward. I'm going back forward. This is good. This is good. Let's go. Okay, we're going to land on this planet. We're gonna do it this time. Stop floating. No. Stop. I wanna not be in orbit. CTRL. Press me down. Please. Okay, there we go. Okay, I'm slowly going towards the planet now. We got this. We got this. That's a big swirly. Am I heading right towards the swirly storm? Because I kind of don't want to be on the swirly storm. It's like the big red spot on Jupiter. Except it's on this planet right here, and I need a suit for this planet. I feel like I'm going too quickly. No, I'm not. Stop moving in that direction. I don't want to move in that direction. Yes. On to the planet. Thank you. Shift! Don't land! Don't land! Don't land in the water! Oh, it's a boat! Look at the boat! That's beautiful! Where is the spot we landed? Oh, we're right next to the giant death swirl. Look at it. It's terrifying. Oh, gosh. Not on the ground. Not on the ground. Not in the water. Hello, giant wave of tornadoes. Okay, it's somewhere around here. Somewhere around here. It's right here. Right here. Let's go. Right here. Right here. Not that fast. No! Come on. Come on. Land. 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 Ah! Not like that. Not like that. Okay. We made it! We made it! And I need to repair headlights and landing gear. Okay. I'm sorry, Mr. Ship Lead. We're not gonna make that same mistake and not. Alright. Hold E to repair the landing gear. And headlights. There we go. Everything is now repaired, and I'm in a weird location. What are you? You are a tree in a box. Oh, shoot. This place actually has things on it. Let's go and explore this place a little bit. That's an interesting looking tree. They remind me of big bonsai trees. Why is it raining from inside of the ground here? What's this? Tornado. Tornado. And that's a skeleton. What do I do with that? Alright, well that was your little study break, but you better get back. Alright, good luck with studying, Kataria. Thank you so much for stopping in. You have a great study night, and thank you. There's so many skeletons here. You can definitely see. I wonder if those were... It looks like docks. There's probably a ship here. Oh. Oh, that's on right on top of me. Please don't. Ooh. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. I don't like this. I do not like this. What is happening? Is this a tornado safe spot? Oh. 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 No. No wonder why there's skeletons everywhere. That's terrifying. Where's my ship? My ship. My ship. Fire jetpack booster. What's this? Let me look at this. Can I do anything with this? I don't know what to do. Pick up scroll. There we go. Wait. Drop scroll. Is that what I was supposed to do? Take up school. Oh, I could just drop the school anywhere. Well, I have this now. Can I do anything with the school? No, where'd it go? Where'd it go? Did I just... That's a scale. Where did I put the school? What's this? Insert school. Ooh. Translate this. Haha, I figured something out, guys. Let's aim right here. To all my friends here at the construction yard, my gratitude for your tireless work. I had given up hope, but I truly believe this cannon may actually succeed where many other attempts have not. Oh wait, we need to start here. Our next step will be to send Privet up to the orbital probe cannon to install a probe tracking system. Nomi writing starts at one point and then branches off, by the way. Are you going gelatinous on us, love? I'm delighted by your words, but they're atypical for you. If I'm ever half as gooey as Mallow and Avon's behave together, Daz, you may launch me from the orbital probe cannon. So, branched off from to all my friends here at the construction yard, gratitude and all of that. What's this? If I know my brother, Avon's, and his spouse will want to launch the probe with as much power as possible, I'm worried the cannon will break under the strain. I propose we give Avon's and Mallow a slightly lower maximum power setting than the absolute maximum possible to create room for their enthusiasm. Our next thought will be to send Privet up to the orbital probe cannon to install the probe tracking system. Okay. So you start at the center, yeah. Oh, I'm on the wall. I'm on the wall. Okay, this is fine. This is what I want to have happen. Okay, on the wall I go. Can I fly? On the heckin' wall, guys. Let's go. Trees detected. Oxygen tank refilled. Heck yeah. There's probably more things over there. I want to interact with this, but I don't know how to. Alright, let's go back on the wall. Let's go on this adventure. There's some skeletons on the wall here. Oh, this is so weird. Into the water. Oh shoot, I can actually do that. Alright, let's go. Oh, this is so weird to look at. Where's the tornado? Don't fall off of that. Oh, this is so weird to look at. I don't. No thanks. Oh, I'm going to be a sick human after this. Alright, onto the floor. Tornadoes are over there. Oh! Hello, Peek-a-Bug! Your mom lets you keep skeletons on the wall. Mine makes you keep them in the closet. Oh my gosh. Control module protection stuff. I'm on an alien planet and there's like 5 tornadoes over there! 5 of them! I don't know why I almost unplugged my headphones. This is a spooky game. Why is the sea level rising? I swear to goodness, if the tornadoes are coming back, I'm gonna cry. Is that going to make the tornadoes come back? What's this? Insert control module projection stone. What does this do? Ooh, more writing. I swear to God, Mr. Tornadoes, I see you there. I see you there. Are you coming back? Excuse me. Are they coming back? Oh god, it's coming back, it's coming back, it's coming back, it's coming back. Onto the tornado plate! I don't know what to do! It's coming back, it's coming back. Look at that, isn't that terrifying? This is a terrifying. Whee! Into the tornado goes my soul! Oh god. I'm into the tornado hole! Into the tornado hole! Put me in the tornado hole! We are inside of a freaking tornado right now. I don't know if I'm supposed to be on this thing when the tornado, but I'm assuming so because there's a picture of a tornado on it. That's my guess. Do I know other than that? No. Oh, God. Ah, back into the hole, back into the hole, back into the hole, back into the hole, back into the hole. Okay, I can't exist. This place is actively terrifying. Why? Wee indeed goes my sanity here in this heckin' space rock in the waves. Okay, let's read this, because I need to read this. Hello, translator. How nice of the sea to give me a bath like that, right? Too close to the target text. Let's go this way. I have bad news, Avens. Yarrow says there was a problem with the proposed power source, so the orbital probe cannon won't be asked to fire. I hope you're pulling my locomotive limb here, Cassava. So apparently they have electronic limbs, but that's all I know. Let's see this one. I wish I were, my friend, but no, they aren't certain they can fix the problem. So the orbital probe cannon is an indefinite hiatus. Tell Privet and Mallow they should return from the cannon. My spouse and I will remain at the construction yard for now. An update. Mallow and I will join you, and Privet left to visit her brother. She fears Adea may feel responsible. Okay. Do I know what's happening? No. Ooh, can I put this? Remove. Equip translator. 16 minutes, 39 seconds ago, long-range probe successfully launched from the orbital probe cannon. Put this down here. Didn't, what did it do? Remove. Insert. Ha! Is this what this place used to look like? Excuse me? Excuse me? Okay, yeah, you know what? Fair enough. That's something that's normal to see. Let's see what this is right here. Hello, what are you? I don't know what that means, but I bet that's important. why is it saying that my ship's getting closer to me? What's happening with my ship? Okay, let's go walk on the wall again, because that's just normal. We'll go this way. We'll see what's on the other side of whatever this is. This is weird to look at. Oh, I'm getting low on oxygen. There's trees this way. That's the wrong direction. Then you go the other side. Good thing I'm looking up there consistently. Trees detected. Oxygen tank refilled. Heck yeah. Alright, let's go again. This game is really cool. This game is super cool. Alrighty. On to this side. Why is the sea actively rising? I swear to goodness. Where are those volcanoes? That's not what I wanted. I'm back on the wall. Okay. There we go. We're good. We're all good. This is what good looks like. I don't want to drop it on that rock. There's another one! That's another skeleton. We'll put that one down right there. Oh, I see the tornadoes. They're coming back! Little hollow. Oh, oh no. I don't like that one. What is happening? Oh no, oh no, oh no. I'm flying. I did not consent to being thrown. We live. Okay, let's go over here. Oh God. That's what I wanted to have happen. Please put me back. Put me back. Put me back. Please. Ow. Okay, where's the tornado hole? Put me in the tornado hole. This is not good. Okay, yeah, I'm in the tornado hole. A little bit too late. This is going great, I tell ya. Weather sure doesn't like me. No, it does not. The weather sure is being lame. Let's put this here. Watch those spin. Tornado screw up. Oh, anxiety is in the finest. Let's see what this says. Connoy. Daz and I were lifting orbital probe cannon components into orbit for assembly, and Winsome has sank down beneath the current. Connoy, you should have seen it. We thought it was impossible for any cannon components to sink, even partially below the current, but ours sank straight to the core. Casanova convinced me to not try to recreate the phenomenon myself using other cannon parts, but we're very curious to know what happened. How could something pass through the current? Oh! Oh no! What? What? Oh! Oh! I hate this! I hate this! Oh, what is happening? Are we moving?! I didn't even get to read the last part! What the heck is that? What the heck is that? Huh. Excuse me. Did I die again? Did I die again? It's purple now. I am so confused! This game is indeed really cool, I agree. Look at those memories playing in front of my eyeballs. Did I die? I died! Why did I die? What was that? Why did I die? I was in the middle of reading stuff. Dude, bro, I'm talking to you. There's our pilot ready to get this beauty off the ground. And what can I do you for? Oh, Oh yeah, it is a death trap, but a really powerful death trap. Wait, you suddenly care about safety now? You're lucky I'm in a time loop, because otherwise I'd be super dead. Oh, it's a time loop! Yeah, that person is a friend. This is what we look like. And you're lucky I don't have you grounded for medical reasons, because I have no idea what you're talking about. Okay. Okay. Let's take... Brett, they are so cute. Look at them. They have little weeb faces. Can't really see that at this moment. Anyways, we need to think. Okay, let's think. We are thinking now. We are in thinking mode. Okay?
Yeah, he's a Shiba.
What? Excuse me? So are you saying, is this what's happening? I was just chilling in a museum. Everything was perfectly fine. Then a statue just moved and it looked into my soul and into my brain space where all my memories were. And everything was fine until then. And did a time loop start at that exact moment? Is this a time loop that started when the fucking statue rock looked into my soul? I appreciate the nice wholesome music whilst I'm like confused as all hell, but okay. So is that what happened? And now we're talking about random weird space planet lobe things that take pictures. Doesn't take pictures? Now I'm confused, getting yeeted all over the place by tornadoes. What is this? Okay, let's go see what everybody thinks. We're gonna talk to everybody, okay? This is gonna be great. We're gonna figure out what's happening more. Hey, Peekabug, look, it's a child. Aren't they adorable? They have little flight goggles. Their name's Micah. They're cute. They think that I'm gonna explode in my ship. Let's go this way now. As my camera goes up and down because I'm heckin' laughing. Hello, guy. Hello, hatchling. I hear you're leaving us to seek an adventure amongst the stars. Literally, I already said this. This has already happened. Okay, so apparently that's not... Right? They're all adorable, and I love all of them. There's two children hiding around here somewhere. Little lad playing a banjo. Also, you can look at the sun, and it's a banjo. Moment of chill time for me to die inside. Okay, I'm confused. That's where we're going. You'll love these guys. Aren't they cute? Like, I love these guys. This is gonna be a game that I put in my vote list every time now because it's too good. It is too good. I love this. Hello, Mr. Geyser. I hear you. Let's go back to the launch tower and figure out what the actual heck is happening because this is interesting. I quite enjoy this. Hello, guy. You know, you probably should ground me for medical reasons at this point, you know, sir. Alright, back into space. I'm going back to that death planet, by the way. This is going to bug me too much to not. Buckle up, let's go into another dimension where the planet wants to yeet us into tornadoes and all of a sudden, random stuff. Look, it's our little village that we're leaving. The place of normalty. I am going back down towards the village. No, thank you. Okay, where is that planet? Ooh, what's that? I want to go there. That's not where I'm supposed to go. There it is. Okay, Death Planet, we're going back to you. I wonder if you get too close to the sun and if it'll start, like, dragging you in. I don't know. Let's keep going towards the sky. Hi. Hello, my bean. If that was my bean.
It was.
Hello. Alright, let's land back in here and figure out what existence even is. Hello, Nikki.
Hi.
Are you happy with your pizza?
I'm very content with my pizza.
I'm glad that you're very content with your pizza.
And
no.
My second can of monster.
Why are you eating so much monster? Drinking monster. No. Fair enough. There you go. Bring me back to this planet of doom with all the Skellamans. Okay, into it we go. No! That's not what I wanted! Put me back! Put me back on the planet, please. Okay, there we go. Hey, look, you can see the little shadow of my ship. Into the death! Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh, no! Well, there we go. Hang on, I'll just turn the flash with this. Okay. Ow! No! Put me back! 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 This is bad! This is very bad! This is very bad! Well, I guess I can repeat. I want back in! Put me in, thank you. Okay, now I have my suit, and now I'm going to be fun. I landed on the same island, too. I can read that last part that it didn't let me read last time. Okay, no, I didn't want... No, let me out. Let me out. I have shit to explore more. Okay, will do. Alright. There it is. Let us go. Let us go. You know, I think I've decided that this is gonna be- there's the scroll. Because everything's exactly the way it was, because freaking time loop! Why can't I get on the wall this time? There we go. Okay, I was about to be very confused. I can't go that way. Okay, and onto the wall, because that's totally not trippy. And... we want to go on that other side. Because I want to read that last part. Alright, pick this guy up because I know exactly where everything is because I've been here before. I see you, tornadoes. Alright, onto the wall. To the other side so we can read that last point. Because I want to have all of it read when I edit this into a YouTube video. Because I think I'm going to, for my next YouTube series, it's going to be Calico. And then it's going to be this. Oh. That's the big one. Hello and goodbye, sir. There we go. Okay. My gratitude for your interesting question. This is exciting. Spire constructed a model of Giant Steep here at Brittle's Hollow Southern Observatory, and it reveals how an object might sink below the current. Kanoi, I am unable to grasp the answer by looking through the projection pool. If I visit the observatory, would you kindly explain? If you don't mind the trek beneath the surface to the South Pole, I'd be delighted to see you. There are two trailheads, one at the Brittle Hollow's Gravity Canyon, and one at Tower of Quantum Knowledge. Okay. Now I also wanted to pick this up and put it in here. Oh. Twisters inside of those. And you're getting smacked with fire rocks. Oh, wow. There's something behind there. Okay. When I edit these videos, it's going to help me figure out what the fuck's happening, I hope. Oh, oh, oh no, oh no, oh no, tornado! Tornado siren noises because Brittle Hollow has to be one of your favorites. It is so cool. It is really cool. is some serious weather on this island. I'm just gonna stay on this for a bit. I think this will be an interesting place to leave it, because I am thoroughly perplexed and confused, and yes, so. Alright, guys, to the talk screen. Thank you so much for chilling with me for this stream of Outer Wilds. This is going on my list. I'm going to play more often. I hope you guys have an amazing rest of your night. I will see you on Minecraft tomorrow. Also, I'm not going to be streaming on Friday next week because I'm going to be on choir tour. So that's a thing. But in any case, I will see you guys later. And yeah, no problem for playing this game. This is a really funny game to play. I love it. So I'm going to play it a lot more often. All right. And thank you so much for the good luck. You guys have a good one. Goodbye.